Morning dear students, you can see on the video that chapter number 1 knowing our numbers is written. This is the first chapter of maths in class 6. I am going to select some topics which you have learned in the previous classes. I am going to teach you again these things so that you can have revision on that topics and some students have missed the previous videos because they were not on the site of Vishnu Bhavan Public School. So I hope you will again learn these things. Beginning of the chapter, start with the natural numbers. You have to understand properly that what are natural numbers. A natural number is a number which is used to count the objects in our environment. Starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. As I have written the definition of the natural number, a natural number is a number which is used to count the objects in our environment, starting from 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Many time when somebody tell you to count the objects, you start from the 1, 2, 3 and so on. So counting numbers are always called natural numbers. After this we have another set of number. What? See here. Whole numbers. Now you have to also understand properly what are whole numbers. Suppose that we don't have any object, so we represent nothing as zero. So this zero is called the whole numbers. How? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, etc. So you can see when we add 0 with the set of natural numbers, the whole set is called whole numbers. Now we will also understood what are digits. To write any number, listen very carefully, to write any number we use symbols like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Remember 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. If you count all these symbols, it is 10 in numbers. So these are called digits. Whatever we are going to make the numbers, these digits will use to write any number or read any numbers. Next thing is numeration. What is numeration? First of all, I will take notation. What are notation? Expressing a number. Listen very carefully. Expressing a number like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This representation is called notation. Other thing, is called numeration. Numeration. Now, numeration. You have to understand what is numeration. Listen, when we write the number name of any number, it is called numeration. For example, I have write here two numbers, 4768 and another number 70476. If we write the number name of the these numbers, this become numeration, like 4768. This is called numeration. I will take another number. How to write the number name of this number? 70,000. 70,476. I repeat the number name 70,476. So I hope you have understood what is the difference between notation and numeration. Notations are here and numerations are here. I don't think there is any problem to understand this properly. Now, I will pick up another topic. The most important thing to read and write the numbers. This is called place value chart. Place value chart. You have learned these things before, but if you revise these things, certainly it will help you. Just see here, place value charts are two in number. First is called Indian place value chart. Other is called international place value chart. Now you will have some question in your mind that what are Indian place value chart, what are international place value chart. You can imagine on your language, like you are Indian, you use Hindi maximum as a mother tongue, and in Western countries maximum people have English language, so they are using the numbers in their own way. They are using the numbers in their own way. So there is a little difference between Indian place value chart and international place value chart. Digits are same for all, but when we write or read the number, use comma differently, and some numbers are different from each other. So again, I will tell you how to draw a place value chart. Just wait, let me adjust this a little bit. Problem also to making this video, because one hand is using for the making video and other hand is for writing, so it is a little bit difficult for me, for every teacher, but we have to manage. Now Indian place value chart. Indian place value chart. As I have told you, this is always helpful to understand the number properly. this will give you correct way of learning. Now I have drawn this. Now I will divide a major blocks like this way, like this way, like this way. So I hope all you can do this at home properly. If you make practice, you will learn how to draw it properly. Now this first row is called period. Remember, I will write here period, remember, and this place is called place value, PV. It is not very clear, but I hope you can understand because you are in 6th class, so it is not difficult for you. This row is called period and this row is called place value, and I will write a number here to make you understand. Starting from right hand side, this period is called ones period, this is called thousands period, this is called lakhs period, and this is called crores period. Now after this block we will have three places, or in other words we can say that ones have three places, 1, 2, and 3, and thousand places are 2 in number, lakhs places are 2 in number, and crore places are 2 in numbers. As you have learned this before also, but it will revise you to better understanding. Again we will separate. You can see periods are major blocks. Look here, I will highlight you so that you can understand it properly. Now once places have unit place, tens place, hundred place, this is called thousand place, 10,000 place, this is lakh place, 10 lakh place, crore place, 10 crore place. So this is called periods, ones, thousands, lakhs, crores. For your class up to 4 is enough. Then this ones period has been divided into 3 parts, unit place, tens place, hundred place. Thousands are divided into 2 parts, 1,000, 10,000. Lakhs period is divided into 2 parts, lakh, 10 lakh, and crores are crore and 10 crore. Suppose that I write a number here, 4176975711. So you can see that I have filled up some numbers in the given cell. Now, right now we will also understand how to place comma. Remember one thing, after writing the number like starting from 4176975711, we use comma in the numbers. Why? Because comma help us to read and write the number properly, and it is easier to understand this. First comma in Indian place value chart is used after 3 digit, 1, 2, 3, like this way. Or another word you can say, we have to separate the numbers by according to the periods. Now thousands have 2 places, 1, 2 after 2 digit, lakhs after 2 place, and but we don't place any comma after the last digit. So I hope you have understand. Now I have told you earlier, notation, listen carefully, notation means numbers. So this is called notation. How can we write as an numeration, when we write the number name of the given number, it become numeration. So reading is also important. How to read this? You can see this 41 is in the crores, so we can write it 41 crore. Then see this number 7 and 6, it is in the lakhs period, so 76, it is lakhs, so we will write lakh. After that, 1000, how much? 97. Look here, 97,000. After that, 571. Now I think this part has finished. Many students were surprised why my sir has explained these things again, because you have learned these things earlier. But remember one thing, whenever you read these things again and again, certainly you will have more understanding, better understanding to know the numbers, because these basics are very, very important. After reading and learning these, you will have more clarity on these numbers. Now I will finish my video here, and I will continue the same thing from the international place value chart, so that you can also understand those part also properly, because many time we have seen that students are able to write the numbers in the Indian system, but they have problem or facing problems in the international place value system. Thank you. Goodbye.